I appreciate every morning when I drive in our home farm and I watch the sun coming up over the fields with the river in the background. I know that I'm doing something good for my family. I know I'm doing something good for the environment, and I know I'm doing something to help feed the world. Not just Maryland consumers, but people across the world. Hi, I'm Chip Bowling. I'm a Maryland farmer. We're on Mount Victoria Road in Newburgh, Maryland, along the Wicomico River.
Pink shirt and the combine. When I drive the combine, I like to wear girly colors, bright pink, purple, and stuff. When people see me driving down the road and the combine, hopefully, number one, they see me. Number two, they kind of give me a double look because they're not used to seeing women and, you know, driving big machineries and stuff like that. I quit my job working at a preschool and decided to hop in a combine and a tractor and learn how to do it. My name is Missy Dooley. We're here at a sorghum farm in Upper Marlboro in southern Prince George's County. We're about to harvest the sorghum. We use my combine, and we usually get about 80 bushels an acre, depending on the soil and if the deer eat it or not.
People drive by, they see me in the fields, they like to see farmers out in the field using the big equipment, but they also like to see the background. They like to see the river in the background. They like to see the geese flying in the fall time. They like to see the deer out in the summertime, unfortunately eating my crops. But that's just a part of the circle of life. That's a part of habitat that we're trying to protect in the Chesapeake Bay area.
We came into this from not farming, and so of course we came into this with a lot of preconceived notions about what farming should be and how farmers should farm, and we wanted to be stewards of the land. My name is Eric De Guzman. I own Dicot Farm along with my wife Megan Ockel. We started this farm in 2015. Where we are in Southern Maryland, we have very sandy soil, and it's really easy to destroy that soil. So we have to be really careful in how we do crop rotation and how we do reduced tillage. It's just a really fragile soil.
The Chesapeake Bay mandate has really publicized how and why we farm the way we do. Other farmers across the country are taking notice of what we're doing because we are improving water quality in the bay. We are improving soil health.
We care about the environment. We want to keep the soil healthy. We don't overuse chemicals.
Maryland has a very strict commitment on water quality. And every farmer here that I know has a plan and they follow it. And they do more than ask. They go above and beyond. My name is Jose Prieto. I'm the owner, one of the owners of the Bay Mushrooms, and I'm also the president of the Anne Arundel County Farmers Market.
Every part of how we farm in this state has something to do with the consumer. The smaller farmers are growing vegetables and raising livestock that go directly to farm markets. The medium and big size farmers that are growing row crops like me are providing the food to feed those animals.
So I'm Megan Ockel. I own Dicot Farm with my husband, Eric. For me personally, I have a background in public health, so like I like the idea of like giving people really healthy food. I mean, I love eating local meat and cheese and eggs. And
we went into this with a certain set of principles, and we wrote them down. We wanted to create community and create healthy people.
I used to go to career day at my son's school, and I would bring chickens and, you know, eggs and, you know, corn and stuff, and I would ask the kids where these products came from, and they all yelled the grocery store. So I taught them everything that they could possibly know. I showed them pictures of the machinery and stuff. This is what I like to do. I like to educate people on farming.
So I talked to many of my partners here, and a lot of them are expanding. They are growing their CSA, the community supported agriculture. They're getting more members. Everybody's on a roll, like they're trying to expand, grow more, because the demand is getting higher.
Okay, I'm Drew Kinoe with Kinoe Poultry. We're over at the Anne Arundel County Farmers Market. It's great when, you know, they like what you're producing. You know, I think a lot of it has to do with the connection that we can make with the buyers.
Yeah, it's about the relationship. And for as a business owner, it's about security. That's everything, is a relationship. Otherwise, you would just go to the store. My name's Adam Cottrell. I own and operate and started Floating Lotus Farmstead. Went back in 2015 with my wife, Jocelyn. I was an electrician. My wife was a makeup artist. And so we quit our jobs and started growing vegetables. Yeah, so we got into farmers markets, direct market sales, fell in love. Well, I guess I was a flea market kid. And here we are, you know, Anne Arundel County Farmers Market.
An old farmer once told me that there's this Amish saying that a dollar goes around, exchanges hands 7 times within the community before it goes out. That's what you're doing when you buy local. You know, you're keeping those dollars in your neighborhood, in your community.
From Mimi to my other organic growers, to my conventional growers, to fruit growers, like the more the merrier here as far as our community. We feel like we're fitting the demand.
When you get a good crop, you feel like all that effort was, you know, somebody's gonna have it on their plate, somebody's gonna share it with their kids, and it feels good.
The more farms that we can preserve and put into preservation, the more that'll be around. That will save our future of farming. And, you know, if we don't have farming, we don't eat. It'll always be something beautiful to look at, no matter, you know, what time of the year it is.
That was the money shot.
This is something who you are, and because there's no other way to put all the hours, all the effort, dealing with failure. You know, when you something fails, you don't give up. You just try it again. You learn something and you try it again. And when you got it, it's just nonstop.
It really gives me some satisfaction. Like now, when we're during harvest, we can reap what we sow, so to speak. And a good harvest makes the year that much more fun.